Hello friends, welcome in the day 4 of the 30 days of code in HackerRank, and this is the problem of the class versus instance. So let's go to the talk section of this problem. So in this problem, you simply check whether a person is young or old or teenager. So after that, you check some other cases, like if the age is less than 0, you simply initialize the age as 0 and then print this sentence, age is not valid, and setting s to 0. So this is for the code talks. So you simply go through the sample input and output, and if you do not understand this code, you simply go through the explanation and you definitely understand the problem. So I simply go my HackerRank editor, and the class versus instance is object oriented programming problem. For this problem, you have not a choice to select the C programming language here. So I simply select the C++ programming language to solve this problem in the HackerRank editor. But at the end of the video, I simply show the C code for this problem. So you need to expand this 3 dot to see the code in the editor, and here is the main function present. So you go through the main function, it simply do the basic job, and here is the get input from user for the t, and then it makes a for loop for t times, and the h time it call to function person and am I old function, and it also get the input from user for the age, and then it also call the year process function for 3 times to increment the age of the person. And this is the basic task of this main function. And in this problem, you need not worry about the main function. You simply complete the 3 functions. One is the person function, here is the am I old function, and the years process function. So I simply complete the first function. So in this function, you simply check if initial age is less than 0 or not. If the age is less than 0, then you simply print, and for the C++, it is a C out to print the output. So you simply print the sentence right here. So you simply copy the sentence and then paste it, and then at the end you put the end L for the C++ program. So you simply initialize the age equal to 0, and after that, so for the else, you simply declare the age equal to initial age. So that's done for the first person function, and then I go to the second am I old function, and then we check simply age is less than 13 or not. If the age is less than 13, you simply print you are young, and then put a full stop here, and at the end you simply type end L for the C++, and then you simply type the else if, and then check age is less than 18 or not. If the age is less than 18, then you simply type C out, and then print your teenager. So that's for all, and then put a end L for C++ program, and then the final else, and then print the you are old, and then put a full stop here. At the end, you simply type end L for the C++ programming language, and that's what done for the am I old function. And you simply go to the third function year process and increment the age by 1. Run the code. So you run the code here. So here shows the wrong answer. So what I missed, that here shows your output, and here shows expected output. So you simply match the 2 output to determine your mistake. Oh, So I miss A before the teenager. So here one A present. So I then run the code. So in this time, congratulation page is present. That means my code is give the right output. So all the test cases are passed. So many times in your code, some silly mistake are present. So you determine the mistake by looking your code very well. So now I show the code that I written for this problem in C programming language. So I simply open my Dev C++ IDE and then go to the file and then open it and I name it class. So this is my file. So I simply open this code. So here is the code for this problem. So if I run this code and give the input same as given in the sample input in the HackerRank problem, like 10, 16 and then 18, it gives the same output as in the sample output. So like I match the output with the sample output. So this is the sample output and here is my output. So you see the two output are same. If we use the text again custom input, so we give an random input like 3, like 10 and then 12 and then 2. So after that we simply run the code and it will give the output as like this. And if I run the code in my ID and then give the same input like 3 and then 10 and then 12 and then 2, I also same output. So you see the my C code is also correct. So I put a link of this code in the description box, so you can download the code from the description box. So that's for the day 4. See you in the day 5. So thank you, friend.